Hi there and welcome to the Floss Marketing School. In this video, I'm just going to make a short introduction to the Raspberry Pi 0W, which is the one that you can see here. It's one of the tiniest Raspberry Pi which exists, as well one of the cheapest. You have another one which is even cheaper than this one. It's just that it does not come with a Bluetooth, neither with a Wi-Fi component, which is the case of the Raspberry Pi 0W. So you have Wi-Fi and you have Bluetooth within this one. It costs about 10 euros. So I really think that actually this Raspberry Pi will not suit the needs of people who really would like to get a computer, because as you can see, you don't really have not that much port over here. So you have one port for the hard drive, you have one mini HDMI, and you have two mini USB ports. And the main issue that I faced is, as you can see, those two ports, those two USB ports are really close to one another. And as a result, every time that you want to plug any additional things to them, such as the possibility to add a keyboard, to add the mouse, and to add as well the energy coming through, you don't have enough space, or the, let's say, the additional port, the extension that you will add, you will see, will hit the following one, and as a result, you can only use one port. So I think that this Raspberry Pi is not, at least for me, not really user friendly in terms of ports, and that's why I strongly recommend you to use it mostly as a server. So that's what we're going to see right now. So in fact, there's a great tutorial that I strongly recommend you to follow, which is the following tutorial. So I followed it in order to install the operating system on it. And what is great is that by following this tutorial for the first time, you don't need to have actually all the keyboards and the mouse on. You just need to follow carefully the tutorial over here, which consists in downloading the operating system, then downloading Etcher, which is here, in order to burn the ISO file on the SD card. And once you have it, then actually from your main computer, you can easily transfer the boot sequence on it, and you can as well control the SSH part. So in fact, you can enable SSH without getting an access yet to the Raspberry Pi, which is great, because like this you can set everything that you need, and once you are doing all of this, you can then access in SSH directly to your Raspberry Pi, which is in fact what I'm doing right now. So I'm just accessing it like this, and now in fact I get an access to my Raspberry Pi without in fact by just going through straight directly through SSH, which is great. And now in fact I can use the Raspberry Pi as a server. So now all I need, for example, to help is Apache. So sudo apt-get install apache 2. Okay, and it's gonna download and install Apache, I hope. Okay, blah blah blah. So okay, yes, install me Apache. So now it's currently installing it on it. Okay. Okay, okay. Close to it. It's a bit slow, because in general Raspberry Pi are a bit slow, and as you can imagine, Raspberry Pi 0W is even slower than this. So still taking some time, but the final idea is, once Apache will be installed, we will see that at the following IP address, which is the one that I use locally for this given Raspberry Pi, I will get Apache. So I can in fact start to set my own website on my local network, and have in fact a server, which is the one of my Raspberry Pi 0W. Okay, So, okay. So just waiting for it. If you'd like to know how much does the Raspberry Pi Zero W cost, as I previously said, those are kind of expensive. In my case, I bought it directly on Qubi, and Qubi I got it at this given price. Okay, so now Apache is installed. So if I just reload this page, as you can see, I'm getting my IP address on. So as a result, I can really use my Raspberry Pi with www, okay, HTML, and then I can, of course, edit the index page by adding everything that I want on it. So in my case, I'm just gonna create one from scratch. Okay, cannot be found, so I'm gonna do it with nano. I'm gonna call it like index two and nano. Okay, go for it. Hello you. Okay, and then let's remove index.1.html. Okay, and let's now change it by index2 into index.html. And that's it. So now I have my own website running on my Raspberry Pi Zero W, which acts as a server on my local network. And of course, after I can decide to open this given website to the outside in order to have my own website hosted on the Raspberry Pi Zero W for nothing. So like this, I control my own server, my own website, and so on and so forth. And that's it for today. So hope you enjoyed this video about the introduction to the Raspberry Pi Zero W. Thanks for watching.